Well, Joe Biden is vowing he will fight until the very end, the US president telling the Democratic governors he just needs more sleep and to stop scheduling events after 8 p.m. But after another misstep in a radio interview, there are growing calls for Biden to step aside.
By the way, I'm proud to be, as I said, the first vice president, first black woman to serve with a black president. I screwed up. I made a mistake. That's 90 minutes on stage. Look at what I've done in 3.5 years.
Political scientist Simon Jackson joins us now. Simon, so great to have you on. I mean, that was a really... It's an interesting comment from President Biden there. It's a mea culpa. Of the, you know, it was 90 minutes. Look at what I've achieved. Will that resonate with people, do you think? Will they cop that?
The problem is that the missteps are getting in the way of Biden being able to tell that story about his own accomplishments. That was true in the debate. It was true just then. You guys led, we led, global media leads with the fluff, and that gets in the way of Biden being able to tell the story about his considerable accomplishments as president. And he's never been a great public speaker throughout his whole life. Yeah. It certainly hasn't gotten any better with age, and that's what people are paying attention to at the moment, the fluff.
I mean, I know the headlines have been pretty ridiculous on some of the some news sites about the fluff, particularly about the black female president comment. I don't know if it was just a run-on sentence and he sort of got confused, but at the end of the day, as the leader potentially of the free world that he's, that's what he's fighting for, you need to be able to have clear messaging. And right now, in the lead-up to the election, he needs to be able to tell people concisely what he's exactly planning for this country.
Exactly. And that's why the debate is so hard to unsee.
Yeah. Exactly.
So they are loading the schedule with events right now to try and get good Biden out there. But again, it's just so hard for people to put the memory of that debate behind. And again, I keep coming back to that. Even at his best, Biden would stutter and stumble. Yep. He's got a stutter from childhood. He's mastered that in public life. He's never been a great public speaker, though, and putting him under this intense scrutiny, I just wonder how productive it's going to be.
He might have a stutter. He doesn't have a conviction, which is which is interesting. I mean, we do Kaboom. Laugh about that, but isn't it funny the amount of coverage that this is getting, and then we're happy to just read on and convicted felon Donald Trump.
I'm so glad you've brought that back into center stage, because what we've done over the last couple of weeks is flip from all the scrutiny being on Trump, convicted felon, awaiting sentencing in New York, to now this focus on Biden, an honourable man, a competent president who is having, frankly, senior moments on the global stage. But this is the problem for Democrats. The conversation has flipped from Trump's fitness to office to the fitness
of... And you know why? You know why? Because we've got probably the best PR strategist in the world in Donald Trump, I would say. There's no one better at recreating a global narrative.
Which is why you can't make mistakes. Which is why you've got to put your best foot forward. And the flip side about Donald Trump is that he's just been handed a blank check by the Supreme Court. An imperial presidency awaits the next occupant of the Oval Office, and I think this is what's giving Democrats palpitations about the prospect of the White House returning to the control of Donald Trump, given what the Supreme Court has signalled about the powers of the presidency.
OK, a lot of chat, obviously, about Biden out, who would be in. Kamala, obviously, would be the most obvious choice, but Michelle Obama, that name is reappearing again. Is there any validity to that, or is that just a rumour?
Look, dynamite poll numbers for Michelle Obama. Absolute rock star. Would shore up the African-American vote in a heartbeat. I'm not sure she wants it, to be honest.
No.
She's never run for elected office. I think she's very happy living her life, her best self, out there doing a lot of things away from elected office. I'd be astonished. You could knock me down if Michelle Obama somehow got into this, despite her stellar poll numbers.
Yeah, and also she doesn't really have a background in it. I know she's fantastic in speeches and I mean, she's an extraordinary speaker. But in terms of policy and actually the nuts and bolts of being the president, does she have the qualifications even for that?
I think she would adapt to it very quickly. I think you get a hell of an insight into what the job entails from being the First Lady of the United States. But I just think the rough and tumble of politics and having to go on the attack in a way that you have to when you're a presidential candidate would be foreign to her.
Yeah. With that dynamite polling, as you call it, Simon, I'm still certain there's been some interesting chats had around the Obama dinner table. We'll see how it
The world is holding its breath.
Thank you very much, Simon.
Pleasure.
We love your analysis.
Thank you.